When it comes to national instruments, you may find that certain parts come in several different connector options. Certain ones may or may not be suitable for your application. In this video, we will discuss these differences, giving better insight on each one's purpose. Typically, you will find these variations across a few different categories of parts, the main ones being NI modules and PXI. These variations can occur and correlate to several different unique part numbers, allowing the user flexibility to accommodate different applications and usage. First, we will go over the NI modules and the four most common variety. To start, the connector refers to the physical component that is used to join a particular part of NI hardware to another product or instrument. The first connector type we'll discuss is the screw terminal. The names are very direct and given, based on how a part connects wires to a sensor. This connector secures the wire against the conductor in the terminal block by tightening a screw which closes the clamp. Screw terminals are a good choice if you are wanting to connect bare unterminated wires to a circuit. Here is our technician demonstrating this process. The second connector type is the spring terminal. This works in similar fashion to a screw terminal, but instead of tightening a screw to make a connection with a wire, a spring will clamp the wire to the sensor, holding in place much better than a screw terminal, due to the tension being automatically adjusted according to the wire gauge. Spring terminals are also better for temperature change, which can cause wires to expand or contract. In order to attach a wire, first, insert a screwdriver into the spring clamp activation slot to open the corresponding connector terminal. Then, press a wire into the open connector terminal. Finally, remove the screwdriver from the activation slot to clamp the wire into place. This diagram demonstrates what is occurring on the inside of the part. Here is our technician demonstrating this process. The third connector type is the D-sub. This connector contains two or more parallel rows of pins or sockets, surrounded by a characteristic D-shaped metal shell, hence its name. It provides stronger mechanical support and ensures the correct orientation while screening against electromagnetic interference. It is one of the most popular electronic connectors in the world, offered in various configurations and sizes, and can be used in many different applications. Here is our technician connecting a compatible cord to a part. The fourth connector type is the BNC, or bayonet needle conman. These are miniature quick connect coaxial radio frequency electrical connectors, developed for low frequency applications. They are used in place of regular coaxial connectors. BNC connectors feature a two-stud bayonet style locking mechanism that twist and lock into position, which indicates a secure connection. It is a close-fitting connection because it is locked by the BNC male connector that has a pin that fits into the main conducting wire, which is then secured in place with an external ring. It turns into a locked position. Here is our technician demonstrating this process. Now, before moving on, let's briefly take a look at an NI module that has two connector types. Sometimes, they can be the same, as seen in the NI9852, or they can be different, as seen in the NI9505. These typically don't have variations, so you won't need to worry too much when it comes time to replace one. The final connector variation of this video will belong to the PXI cards. They can come in either a standard PXI connector type, which can only read in standard PXI chassis, or they can come in the more popular hybrid connector type, which offers the ability to work in both PXI and PXIE chassis. These will typically be the only variants of these parts. With that, this concludes the video. We hope this was helpful. If you have any questions about these different connectors or about parts in general, feel free to reach out to us by visiting our website at www.apexwaves.com. Thanks for watching!